So you killed that sock, huh?
Yeah.
Good going. We always thought you were a smart guy, but at least you're not in a reformatory. We'll get as much socks as possible. You better stay close.
Hello, Daryl. Long time no see.
Hi, Paul. So, what's up with them? They used to play football together. You know, before Mr. and Mrs. Curtis. Oh, yeah.
I'll take you.
Hey, you guys aren't starting this without me.
Okay, I can't exactly make the scene where they fight because that would take forever to edit. Okay, fine. So it went like.
Good night, and always remember, that's...
Yeah.
Yahoo! Hooray!
Pony boy, are you okay?
Come on, let's tell Johnny. Play sick. I'm taking you to the hospital.
Now just what do we have here?
Well, this kid fell off his motorcycle, and I'm taking him to the hospital.
How bad is he?
Who knows? That's why I was rushing.
Okay. Better be more careful in the future.
Dummy! Damn it. If you were smart like me, we wouldn't have gotten Johnny in this condition. You better wise up, before things get crazier. Yo, Johnny. We beat the Sox.
That's useless.
Huh?
Fighting doesn't solve the problem.
Well, you're gonna be alright. At least you did something heroic.
Pony boy? Stay gold, pony boy. Stay gold.
Johnny? Come on. So this is what you get for saving people. Please don't die on me, Johnny. Hey, you're not supposed to be here. I'll go wherever the hell I want. Why does the hospital even bother helping people? They didn't give a shit about Johnny.
This guy had sharp teeth. Where have you been? Pony boy, what's wrong?
Johnny's dead. I told him about us beating the Sox, but he just passed. He told me to stay gold. Dallas was more overwhelmed than me. He might do something bad.
You know you have to pay for that, sir.
Hey! Cut it out. Give me your money.
Ah!
Give me your freaking money.
Okay. Okay. Good thing I've kept a gun of my own.
Hello. This is Steve. Can I talk to Derry? It's urgent. Okay. Derry, it's for you.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I just robbed the store. The cops are after me. Meet me at the park?
Sure thing. Are you alright?
Yeah, about Johnny.
We know. See you later. That was down. The cops are after him. You must stay him.
Ugh. Put your hands up. You're not taking me alive.
Ah, he has a gun. Open fire.
No! Stop! It's not loaded.
Please
don't. He's just a kid.
Please don't shoot. Please.
Please don't kill Dallas. Pony?
Damn bastards. He wasn't even ill. Do your stinking jobs correctly.
Eventually, it was time to head to court. You know. Because of Johnny's incident.
Let me get this straight. Your name is Shirley, but your nickname Cherry.
Yes.
So did Bob get offended over something?
Yes. I was at the movies with some other guys beside him, and he eventually became jealous.
They chased us and tried to drown me in a fountain and beat up Johnny.
We wanted to teach them a lesson. You know, not to be around our woman.
I shouldn't have made it simpler for it to not go too far.
Ponyboy Curtis is not guilty. He will remain in the custody of his older brother Daryl. This court is adjourned.
Yes!
Hey, Pony Boy.
Oh, hi, Mr. Symes.
I'd like to talk about your grades.
How am I doing exactly?
Hard to say this, but you're failing.
Ah, whoops.
Well, tell you what. If you can write a good summary, I'll pass you.
Shouldn't it be like a research paper?
Well, kinda.
Great! My first trip to the zoo.
Look, just because we lost two girl people on the same night, doesn't mean you can't earn a scholarship. I assumed you'd be less dumb.
Oh, you just want me to be a failure. Just like almost everybody.
Both of you shut up.
What's wrong with you? You catch up, I'll be behind you.
Okay. Soda, stop!
Gee, Pony Boy, you should do track or something.
Just where do you think you're going?
I don't know. I have to get out of these fights. I feel like the middleman in a giant war between you two. I just can't take sides. Pony Boy, Derry kept talking about putting you in a boys' home because he wasn't able to finish college. It would have made things easier. And I have to work at a gas station because I am too dumb for education. Derry, you can't keep yelling at him for the littlest mistakes. He has more feelings than you. And when I'm left to take sides, we're all we got left now. If we don't get together, we'll all be like Dallas. Not dead, but like before. So please, don't fight anymore.
Sure. I won't be pushing Pony anymore. I promise.
Pony? Don't start, Pony. One prayer baby in the family is good enough.
I'm not crying.
Let's go home. It's freezing out here. Raise your guys.
What's this note in my book?
Pony Boy, I asked the nurse to give you this book so you can finish it. It was worth saving those kids. They have more to live for. You should probably tell Dally. I'm gonna miss you guys. I was thinking about Robert Frost's poem. He meant to stay gold as a kid. Like the way you dig sunsets. Keep it that way. I want you to ask Dally to look at one. I don't think he saw one before. There's plenty of good in the world. I don't think he knows. Your buddy Johnny.
When I step out into the bright sunlight, I have two things on my mind, Paul Newman and a red home.
Seize upon the moment.
The Outsiders is a 1967 novel by S.E. Hinton, which then got a movie in 1983. S.E. Hinton is 71 years old today. She also played as the nurse for Dallas in the film. Speaking of the film, it had to be remade because it didn't show all of the chapters. So later, Francis Ford Coppola did a remake that said the complete novel. Patrick Swayze, who was the actor of Derry, sadly died from pancreatic cancer back in 2009. He lived by 57.
You guys do know I'm still here?